Good morning, everybody. In the last class, we discussed some important concepts in the circles. Now, today, we are going to discuss some more important concepts. So, here the first point is general form of circle. Now, we have to find out the general form of a circle. Before that, one important question is, what is the general equation of second degree? General equation, general form of second degree equation. Say, suppose ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. So this is the general equation of, this is the general form of second degree equation. This is the general form of second degree equation. Already we know about this equation in your previous class, pair of straight lines. In first year, in pair of straight lines topic, we see this equation. This is the general form of second degree equation. This is the general form of second degree equation. So, here what I am saying is, here A comma, H comma, B comma, G comma, F comma, C are real numbers, are real numbers. Now, from this second degree equation, we are going to find out the general form of a circle. So, if the second degree equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 represents a circle, then the equation must satisfies three conditions. So, what are the three conditions? The first one is a is equal to b. First condition is a equal to b. What is A and what is B? Coefficient of x square and coefficient of y square must be equal. And second condition is h equal to 0. What is h? Coefficient of xy. Coefficient of xy is h. So that h must be equals to 0. And third condition is g square plus f square minus c. G square plus f square minus c is greater than 0. G square plus f square minus c is greater than 0. So these are the three conditions. If a is equal to b and h equal to 0 and g square plus f square minus c greater than or equal to 0, then the second degree equation represents a circle. Second degree equation represents a circle. So, from these three conditions, what we know? In the second degree equation, coefficient of x square and coefficient of y square must be equal. And h equal to 0. H equal to 0 means there is no xy term in the equation. And g square plus f square minus c greater than or equal to 0. If these three conditions will be satisfied by a second degree equation, then the equation is said to be a circle. So now, say, general form of a circle. Very, very important concept, general form of a circle. What is the general form of a circle? X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. It is also a second degree equation. In this equation, you have to observe a is equal to b.
A means coefficient of x square and coefficient of y square. So B is equal to coefficient of y square. So here coefficient of x square is 1 and coefficient of y square is 1. Therefore A equal to B. So first condition is satisfied. And what is the second condition? H equal to 0. H equal to 0 means there is no xy term in the second degree equation. So in this equation there is no xy term. Okay, and g square plus f square minus c is always greater than or equal to 0, then only it is a circle. So these three conditions will be satisfied by this equation. So the equation x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 is the general form of a circle. Now what the point here is, if this equation x square plus y square plus 2ex plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 represents a circle, then what my question is, if it is a circle, then it has a center and it has a radius. So now we are going to find out the center and radius of a circle in general form. Center and radius of a circle in general form. So we are going to find out the center and radius of this circle. So see, so to find out the circle of this equation g x square plus, first of all I write x terms, the two x terms at this bracket, in this bracket, and the two y terms in this another bracket, and we send this c to this side, it is minus c. Here it is plus c, then it goes to other side, it becomes minus c. So this x square and this 2gx will be kept in one bracket, and y square and 2fy terms, both are y terms, keep in another bracket, and the constant c will be sent to that side, then it becomes minus c. So now it is x square plus 2gx plus y square plus 2fy equal to minus c. Now x square plus 2gx, I add a g square in this bracket, and y square plus 2fy plus f square in this bracket. Here we add g square and f square. So to keep there is no change in this value, we add same g square and f square to this side also. So then g square plus f square minus c. Are you understand or not? I add g square and f square on both sides. Add g square and f square on both sides, and for my convenience, this g square will be written in the first bracket and f square will be written in the second bracket. So now this is a square plus 2ab plus b square, and this is, so it will be written as a square plus 2ab plus b square. It is nothing but x plus g whole square. It is x plus g whole square plus it is y plus f whole square. This is also a square plus 2ab plus b square. That means a plus b whole square. So it is y plus f whole square is equal to g square plus f square minus c. Now I write it as x minus of minus g, this plus, minus into minus it becomes plus. So for my convenience I write it as x minus of minus g whole square plus y minus of minus f whole square is equal to g square plus f square minus c. Sorry, this is whole square. Okay, now this is the first equation. Compare one with standard form of a circle, x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to r square. So compare this equation with this equation. Then what is this equation, x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to r square? This is the equation of a circle having center h comma k.
So center h comma k is equal to, sorry, center c denoted with c, h comma k is equal to.
So when we compared this equation with this equation, clearly observe x minus of minus d, x minus h whole square whole square. So what is in place of h? We have minus d here. In place of h, we have minus g here.
So the center C minus g comma, and whereas in place of k, here we have minus f. So minus g minus f.
Center is C minus g minus f. And radius,
radius r is equal to,
what is here r? R is equal to, radius is equal to r. In place of r here, g square plus f square minus c. So this is r square. So
radius r square is equal to g square plus f square minus c. Then r is equal to root of g square plus f square minus c.
So here center is minus g minus f. R is equal to g square plus f square minus c. Are you understand or not? So what I am saying is, general form of a circle. In this chapter, in any problem, we have to take general form of a circle. Suppose we have to find out the equation of a circle, then let the equation of a circle be taken in the form of this equation. It is the general form of the equation. X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 is the circle. Then its center is minus g minus f, very important. Its center is minus g minus f, and radius of this circle r is equal to root of g square plus f square minus c. Are you understand or not? Suppose, so this root value will be defined only if this is greater than 0. It is greater than 0, then only it is a real number. So g square plus f square minus c must be greater than 0. That is the third condition which we discussed earlier. So r is equal to root of g square plus f square minus c is the radius. For suppose if the radius of this circle is 0, r is equal to 0. Radius r is equal to 0, then the circle is called point circle. Are you understand or not? If the radius of the circle is 0, then the circle is called point circle. And whenever you observe the given circle is a point circle, then you have a clear cut idea that the given circle's radius is 0. If the radius of a circle is 0, then only the circle is called as a point circle. Okay, understand? So if g square plus f square minus c equal to 0, then the circle x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 represents a point circle. If g square plus f square minus c equal to 0, then the circle x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 represents a point circle. So here I introduce one more concept, point circle. Are you understand or not? What is point circle? If the radius of a circle is 0, then the circle is called point circle. And the center, point circle means, suppose the point circle contains, or point circle having center only, CH comma K, but there is no radius here. So the center itself is called as a point circle. Understand or not? The center itself, because there is no distance from the center to any point. So the center itself is a point circle. So this is the concept of a point circle. If any circle having the radius is 0, then that circle is called point circle. So once again I repeat, what is the important concept? It is general form of a circle. So x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 is the general form of a circle. If x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 represents a circle, then what is the center of that circle and radius of that circle? So I derive in this procedure, if x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 is a circle, then center is minus g comma minus f. It is a very very important formula. Center minus g minus f for this circle, and radius r is equal to root of g square plus f square minus c. Okay, next concept we have to see. So next most important concept is concentric circles. Concentric circles. What is concentric circles? The definition of concentric circles is, if two or more circles having the same center, if two or more circles having the same center, then the circles are called concentric circles. So try to understand. Suppose this is the center of this circle. This is the center of this circle. Now there is another circle like this. It is also having this same center. This is another circle. Here you observe three circles, but what is common for both these three circles is center C. So the C, H, comma K, say C, H, comma K is the center of this circle and this circle. So these three circles having only one center, having the same center. So then these circles are called concentric circles. These circles are called concentric circles. It's a very, very important concept. What is concentric circles? If two or more circles having the same center, two or more circles having the same center, then the circles are called concentric circles. Suppose here this is a circle having this center, and this is another circle, this is the center. Here there are two circles and there are two different centers for both the two circles. This center is belongs to this circle and this center is belongs to this circle. Then these two are not called as concentric circles. These are not concentric circles because here two circles have two different centers. But in this case, the three circles are having only one center, having same center. So these three centers are called concentric circles. For this, suppose x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 is a circle. Concentric with is very important note. X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c dash equal to 0. What you observe? Here there are two circles. What is the relation between these two circles? These two circles are concentric circles. Then their equations are like this. If the first equation is x square plus y square plus 2x plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, Second circle equation is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c dash equal to 0. So only constant value, c value will be changed in the concentric circles. Remaining equation will become same. Remaining equation will be same, only constant will be varies. Only constant varies, then the circles are called concentric circles. Very important concept. It is very useful in doing our problems. So, please take a look. If x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0 is a circle concentric with x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c dash equal to 0. So only constant varies in concentric circles. Okay. Next concept. Concentric circles, already I told you about point circle. What is point circle? If a circle having 0 units radius, if a circle is having 0 units radius, then the circle is called point circle. Like that, unit circle. What is unit circle? We are going to discuss about what is unit circle. If the radius of a circle is unity, radius of a circle is unity. Unity means radius r is equal to 1, then the circle is called unit circle. Understand? So if the radius of a circle is unity, that means radius is equal to 1, then the circle is called unit circle. So next concept we will take, general form of a circle. Already you know, general form of a circle is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. If the circle passes through origin, what is origin? 0, 0, then the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy equal to 0. You have to observe, if the general form of a circle is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. If this circle passes through origin, what is origin? 0, 0. Then the circle equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy equal to 0. What we observe, if the circle passes through origin, then there is no constant term in the equation. There is no constant term C in this equation. Whenever it is possible, if and only if this circle passes through the origin, 0, 0. So, observe. Suppose if it passes through origin, what is x? 0 and y is 0. Substitute 0, 0. Here is 0, it is 0, plus 2g into 0, 0, plus 2f into y, 0, or 0, plus c equal to 0. So finally, all are zeros, c equal to 0. Therefore, the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy equal to c, equal to 0, because the c value becomes 0 if the circle passes through origin. So this is one more important. And now the most important one is suppose this is x axis and this is y axis. A circle is like this.
and the here is the center C.
Here equation of a circle having the center on equation of a circle having the center lies on x axis. What is here? Center lies on x axis. Already you clearly know any point on x axis, any point on x axis is in the form of x comma 0. So any point on x axis is in the form of x comma 0. Okay. So x comma 0 means y coordinate is 0. Y coordinate is 0. Generally what we say for this circle, what is center? Already we know minus g minus f. So f value is 0. What is 0? F is 0. So substitute f value 0 in this equation, then the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2gx plus c equal to 0. Understand or not? What you observe here is the equation of a circle having the center on x-axis. So the center of the circle lies on x-axis. But what you know, any point on x-axis is in the form of a comma 0. So here this is center. From this equation, what is center? Minus g comma minus f. But the center lies on x-axis, f is 0. So the center is minus g comma 0. So if the center of this circle lies on x-axis, what value becomes 0? F is 0. So the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2gx plus c equal to 0. And one more equation, if the circle having the center on y-axis, suppose the circle is like this and here is the center. What happens here? Center lies on y-axis, but any point on y-axis is in the form of 0 comma f, 0 comma minus f. So here what is 0? Minus g. G is 0. So g is 0, then the equation becomes. So equation of a center, equation of a circle having the center lies on, having the center lies on, having the center lies on y-axis. So center lies on y-axis, then the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. X square plus y square plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. So are you understand or not? So the three important concepts I discussed here is, take a look once again. This is the general form of a circle, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. This is the general form of a circle. Suppose if a circle passing through origin, then the general form of the circle becomes if the circle passing through origin, then the general form becomes. Suppose if the circle passing through origin, then circle passing through origin, this point 0 comma 0 lies on this circle. So we substitute x comma y as 0 comma 0 in this equation. This is 0, 0, 0, plus c equal to 0. Finally c equal to 0. So the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy equal to 0. So if a circle passing through origin, then there is no constant term in that circle. That is the point you have to remember. If a circle passing through origin, then there is no constant term in the circle. And what is the second concept? Equation of a circle having center lies on x-axis. Equation of a circle having center lies on x-axis. Here what happens? observe here. The center of the circle lies on x-axis. Okay, if center lies on x-axis, any point on x-axis is in the form of a comma 0. That means it is having x coordinate but no y coordinate. So like that, for this equation, what is center? Minus g minus f. But if this circle's center lies on x-axis, x coordinate is same. So minus g. Okay. But whereas y, there is no y coordinate, so y value is 0. Y coordinate value is 0. What is y coordinate in this center? Minus f, it becomes 0. So center becomes minus g comma 0. Then the equation of this circle is in this form of x square plus y square plus 2gx plus c equal to 0. Are you observed it or not? Are you understand or not? Why f equal to 0? Because of f equal to 0, here f equal to 0, this term will be totally deleted. Then the remaining equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2gx plus c equal to 0. Next, equation of a circle having the center lies on y axis. So observe here, if the center lies on y axis, then the point becomes 0 comma minus f. Then the point becomes 0 comma minus f, center becomes, because center lies on y axis, any point on y axis is in the form of 0 comma b something, that means x coordinate is 0. So in the center, minus g is the x coordinate, it becomes 0, so g minus g value becomes 0 comma minus f. Then the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. So because of g equal to 0, this term completely deleted from this equation. Then the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. So clearly understand these three points. One is equation of a circle passing through origin is x square plus y square plus 2x plus 2fy equal to 0, where there is no constant term. If the equation of a circle having center lies on x-axis, x square plus y square plus 2gx plus c equal to 0, there is no y term in this equation. And the equation of a circle having the center lies on y-axis, then there is no question of x term, and the equation becomes x square plus y square plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Okay. So next concept. So I think all of you clearly understand this concept. Suppose if you don't understand this concept, simply you pause this video and reverse the video, then you see again. Rewind the video and see again. One or two times you are going to this video, you compulsory understand the clear concept what I told you. So once you have knowledge over concepts, then you do any problem in these circles very easily. Without knowing the concept or without having a clear idea on concepts, it is highly tough to solve the problems. Once your concepts are cleared, then the problems are so easy. Suppose here I draw three kinds of diagrams. You have to observe first of all. three kinds of diagrams are here. What we observe,
this is x-axis, this is y-axis, it is origin, it is x-axis, it is y-axis, x-axis, y-axis, and this is origin.
Okay. In the first diagram, the circle touches the x-axis at only one point, touches the x-axis. In the second diagram, the circle cuts the x-axis at two distinct points, say A1, and suppose this is A2. And in the third diagram, the circle does not touch x-axis or does not intersect x-axis. There is no relation between x-axis and this circle. And there is no contact. There is no contact between x-axis and this circle. So these are the three cases. In the first case, the circle touches the x-axis. So if a circle, so our general form is, general form of our circle is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus c equal to 0. If the circle touches x-axis, then the condition is g square minus c equal to 0. Circle touches x-axis, then the condition is g square minus c equal to 0. If g square minus c equal to 0, then the circle touches x-axis at only one point. If g square minus c greater than 0, g square minus c greater than 0, then the circle intersects at x-axis at two points. Are you understand or not? If the circle intersects x-axis at two points, then the condition is g square minus c greater than 0. And if g square minus c less than 0, g square minus c less than 0, then there is no relation between x-axis and the circle. That means there is no contact between x-axis and the circle. Okay. Here, the circle touches x-axis if g square minus c equal to 0. Okay. But whereas in this case, it is a very important case. Here, the circle intersects x-axis at two points, say A1 and A2. That means here, the circle forms an intercept on x-axis. What is that intercept? A1, A2 is the intercept. The length between A1 and A2 is the distance between A1 and A2 is the length of the intercept made by the circle on x-axis. Length of the intercept made by the circle on x-axis. Okay. So, let us see how to find out the intercept made by the circle on x-axis. Okay. So, before finding out the length of the intercept made by the circle on x-axis, first of all, you have a knowledge on these three conditions. First condition is, a circle touches x-axis, circle forms an intercept on x-axis, and there is no contact between x-axis and the circle. Okay. If g square minus c equal to 0, this condition, g square minus c greater than 0, then intercept is formed by the circle on x-axis. G square minus c less than 0, there is no contact between circle and the x-axis. Suppose, in the second condition, so we go through this second condition. X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. This is the circle equation. So, if it cuts x-axis, then what happens? Any point on this is in the form of a comma 0. any point on the circle, any point on x-axis is in the form of a comma 0. So say that a1 is like x1 comma 0 or a2 is x2 comma 0, like this there. So for generalized, if it cuts x-axis, then y equal to 0. Y coordinate is 0. So the equation becomes x square plus y value 0, so 0, plus 2gx plus 2f into 0 plus c equal to 0. So x square plus 2gx plus c equal to 0. The first equation. So this is x square plus 2ex plus c equal to 0. Kabatti here this is 2, say 2. So 2 is a quadratic equation in x. So its determinant, is b square minus 4ac. B square minus 4ac. So 2 is a quadratic equation in x. It has a two roots, say x1 comma x2. Two is a quadratic equation in x. It has two roots, say x1 comma x2. X1 comma x2 are the two roots. Then what happened here? Suppose let a x1 comma 0 distance from origin to this point, it is x1 units, and distance from it is x2 units. So length of a1 a2 is x1 minus x2. So for that we have to derive these things. So 2 is a quadratic equation in x. It has two roots, say x1 comma x2. Suppose if the roots are real, then if their roots x1 comma x2 are real roots, then its discriminant b square minus 4ac is always 0. So sum of the roots, what is sum of the roots? X1 plus x2 is equal to sum of the roots ki formula minus b by a. So minus 2g by a means x square coefficient 1, so it is minus 2g. And product of roots x1 x2 is equal to c by a. So what is here? C by a means 1 equal to c. Now length of the intercept a1 a2 is equal to, what happened here? Mod a1 a2 length. So this point origin nunchi a2 kuna length entandi x2, and origin nunchi a1 kuna length entandi x1. Kabatti ee mottham a1 ki deeniki madhyalo unna length kavali. We have to find out the distance between a1 and a2. So it is nothing but oa2 minus oa1. So this is mod x2 minus x1. a1 a2 is equal to mod, because length is always positive, mod x2 minus x1. Are you understand or not? A1, we have to find out the length of the intercept. What is length of the intercept? What is intercept here? A1, A2. So we have to find out the length of A1 to A2. So to find out A1 to A2, first we take from origin to A2. This length is nothing but x2, because of this x coordinate is x2. So this is x2 minus this one. What is this one? X1. So x2 minus x1. So now we have to find out x2 minus x1 value. So this can be written as x1 plus x2 whole square minus 4x1 x2 root of. How can we say that? It is in the form of a minus b. A minus b formula, root of a plus b whole square minus 4ab. Root of a plus b whole square minus 4ab ante a minus b whole square. And x1 minus x2 or x2 minus x1, anything is same. Whole square. Square and root will be cancelled, then x1 minus x2 will be obtained. So this is equal to root of
What is 2z? Minus x1 plus x2 minus 2g whole square minus 4. What is x1 into x2? C. So this is 4g square minus 4c. Root of. So 4 common ka byte ko stay 2. Root of g square minus c.
So length of the x-intercept is equal to 2 into root of g square minus c.
So length of the x-intercept 2 into root of g square minus c.
Similarly, if the circle is like this, that means the circle forms intercept on y-axis, then the formula is 2 root of f square minus c. So very clearly I tell you, two important formulas you have to remember. One is length of the intercept made by the circle on x-axis. Length of the intercept made by the circle on x-axis is 2 into root of g square minus c. Length of the intercept made by the circle on y-axis is 2 into root of f square minus c. You have to follow this very, very clearly, and you must remember these two formulas. It is very important for your problematic part. This is the formula for length of the intercept made by the circle on x-axis is 2 into root of g square minus c. And next one is length of the intercept made by the circle on y-axis is 2 into root of f square minus c. Okay. Understand or not? So, friends, today we stop our class here, and I request all of you to see once again today's class and yesterday's class. You have to see once again, and you must get a perfect knowledge on concepts. Once you clearly understand the concepts, then our problems is very, 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 very easy. So take a look, thoroughly look, and if you have any doubts in the yesterday's class or today's class, you have to comment on your YouTube channel. You put a comment there, what is your doubt, then I go through those doubts and I will explain in the next class. So these are the most important concepts we discussed in yesterday's class and today's class. These two classes are very important. On tomorrow we see parametric equations of a circle. We see parametric equations of a circle, and that is the last concept. After that parametric equations of a circle, we go through the problems. We go to the some important problems. Okay, thank you for your cooperation. Okay, bye.